Hello, everyone. It is review time, and this one right here is for the brand new Judd Apatow movie. It is The King of Staten Island. Stars Pete Davidson as Scott. He's a guy in his mid-20s. He's got no job, but he's still living at home with his mom, who's played by Marisa Tomei. Not only is he having a really tough time just getting it together, but then his mom starts dating someone, and that doesn't sit very well with Scott, who's still struggling with the loss of his father. It's crazy because even in that mere two-sentence synopsis right there, you really do get a sense of how much ground is covered in this movie, and I know it's a bit of a thing that Apatow's movies are on the long side, but personally that does tend to work for me because it gives you more time to really live with the characters, and that winds up making their growth in the movie even more powerful. And I would say that is definitely the case with Scott's journey here. His dad was a firefighter and he died when he was 7. Scott dreams of becoming a tattoo artist but isn't really making any significant steps forward to actually getting there. His sister, played by Maud Apatow, who's quite good in the movie, is an overachiever, and that strains their relationship. And then he's got a group of friends who wind up putting him in a not-so-great situation. And of course, on top of all that, there's also the issues that arise when his mom starts dating this guy, Ray, who's played by Bill Burr. It is a lot, no doubt, but it works for a number of reasons here. And in a way, it does make me think a little bit of Funny People, because there is a point in King of Staten Island where I did think to myself, well, this could have been two movies, but I also still think that the script weaves Scott's challenges together so well that it justifies them all being there together by just showing how one winds up amplifying the other, and then the same winds up becoming true when Scott starts to learn from his past and some of his mistakes as well. So I think it justifies the runtime. And then there's also the sincerity of Pete Davidson's performance in this role. The story is inspired by his own experiences to a degree, and I would say that you really can feel it, whether it's through his reaction shots or his chemistry with the rest of the ensemble. There is this quality to him where you can't take your eyes off of him, and even when Scott makes bad decisions, your heart kind of hurts for him. And I know this is all probably making it sound like King of Staten Island is a straight-up drama, which it isn't, but I will say that it does lean into the more serious stuff more than I had originally expected. But this is a Judd Apatow movie starring Pete Davidson. There are laughs and just enough levity here to never take away from the fact that these are very serious matters that greatly affect Scott's life, but also without ever wallowing it. The whole supporting ensemble here also needs a big shout out, and I'd say especially that's the case for Marisa Tomei and Bill Burr. If you want to see an example of how big subtlety can play in a heated moment, just keep an eye on Tomei's mannerisms and body language in certain scenes here. And that's something that really does suit that character well, because she loves her son and doesn't want to hurt him, but she also wants to encourage him to build a life for himself. And then the back and forth between Burr and Davidson are probably some of my favorite parts of the movie. And actually, now that I'm saying that, I think one of my favorite scenes of this entire movie is Bill Burr's very first scene in it. But the relationship between Ray and Scott here is just one heck of a roller coaster, and I was so impressed by how Burr and Davidson just nail every single beat of it. I also think the naturalism of Judd Apatow's movies is one of their best qualities, but I think it might be even more apparent here with Scott's journey and also with how he captures Staten Island. And I know this is going to sound like a major cliche, but I do think this is the kind of story that needs it, where the location does wind up feeling like a character. You need it in order to make Scott's world feel full. And I would say the style, the tone, and the cinematography is something that really contributes to making that quality a rousing success here. I'm going to go ahead and give The King of Staten Island 4 Deweys out of 5 on the Dewey Decimovie scale. Again, I think the 2-hour-plus runtime was needed to tell Scott's story, but admittedly, there are a few scenes, or maybe just beats here or there, that do feel like they weren't entirely necessary and might have contributed to a quicker pace here and there, but those are really few and far between and not especially noticeable, because Apatow builds a world and a group of characters that you genuinely want to spend more time with. I'd say for anyone who's ever felt stuck and is either having a tough time putting a finger on precisely why, or maybe you can identify those obstacles, but find that they're just kind of like sitting right there in front of you and you can't really seem to climb over them, I just really recommend checking this one out. It's a movie that doesn't identify the struggle, solve it, and then move on from it. It really respects that kind of dull ache or that seemingly unliftable weight that could be holding you back. And that just really made Scott's journey way more powerful than what I was expecting going in. So there you guys go. Those are my thoughts on The King of Staten Island. If and when you see the movie, you know what I really like you to do. Hit the comment section below. Share your thoughts right there. And before I say goodbye to you, we got to give a very special shout out to the Patreon team member who made this video happen, and that is Billy. Billy, you're the best, man. Thank you so much for all the continued support and for being such a positive influence in the Slack channel. I think so, so highly of you, man. Guys, big thanks to everybody out there watching this video. Do not leave it without liking and sharing it, and I'll see you soon with more movie reviews.